How's it going, lads and ladies? My name is Josh, and today I welcome you back to episode number 36 of the Pokemon Sun Let's Play. In today's episode, we're going to be taking on the final two members of the Alolan Elite Four, and then possibly, maybe, I don't know though, maybe the champion. I don't think so, because that would mean it would be the last episode of the LP, possibly. I don't know. We might do some more afterwards, going to find all the Ultra Beasts and everything, but at a particular point in time, we just want to finish the main story, and then think about that afterwards. So, we're going to go straight into it. You guys already know the team. It's the same team from the last couple of episodes. But we're leading off with Beatdown. I've healed everyone up a little bit. And I'm leading off with Beatdown because I do think that this is Nanu we're going to face now. Because he was the Kahoon. Oh, no, it's... interesting. So Nanu is not Nanu. We've got to have something to deal with ghost types. So we've got... I think we've got to lead off with Robin here. I'll just go for Spirit Shackles every 2 seconds. Because it is Acerola. Why is it Acerola? Why isn't it Nanu? Hiya, Acerola here, bringing an old royal touch to the Pokemon League. I still don't understand why she's the Elite Four member and it's not Nanu, because I'm pretty sure Nanu was the Kahuna. Nanu said maybe he can't refuse a Tapu choosing him to serve as Kahuna, but he'd be darned if he had to serve as one of the Elite Four just because some guy asked him. Okay, fair enough. So I guess I'm just going to have to battle hard enough to make up for him not being here. Alright, so you just got to whip her ass instead. Fair enough. We should be able to... I don't think this will take long. We should be able to be. As long as we can get one Swords Dance up, we should be fine. One, I mean, maybe one. One Swords Dance, possibly. Unless he's going to lead off with Sableye, obviously. Right. Either way, I'm still going for the Swords Dance. He went for an attack. He didn't go for a Willow, maybe? No, he went for Shadow Claw. This is going to do a decent amount. Jesus, that did more than a decent amount. Okay. We've just got to hope he doesn't go for a Shadow Claw at some point. Shadow Claw again, fair enough. Right, this is going to start getting annoying, I can already tell. What do we do about this? I think we just got to go for the attack here. Do you know what we're going to do? Let's go for the Sinister Arrow Raid. Because I feel like this is going to be the only ghost type we can't hit super effectively. So that's what we're going to do. Robin, destroy him! Plus two Sinister Arrow Raid. This is, he's not living this. There's no way. If he does, I'll be very surprised. I'll be incredibly surprised if he lives this. No, never mind, that's good. Right, we're still at plus two, which is good. Unless he brings out a Gengar now, we should be okay. Frostlass. We're not faster than Frostlass, but we can get off a plus two Sucker Punch, which will do a decent amount. At least I think it might even kill, actually. It does kill. Right, we're good. So we're in a position now where we're doing pretty well. This I don't think Delmize is going to die to a Spirit Shackle. We've got to try it though. Plus two Spirit Shackle, are we going to kill? Yeah, we are, Jesus. Okay, so we're sweeping. This has been the easiest member of the Elite Four so far. Palossand is coming out. Okay, so Palossand might be a bit of an issue. What do we go for? The Spirit Shackle or the Leaf Blade? Which one's more powerful? Leaf Blade's base 90, Spirit Shackle's base 80, so we have to go for the Leaf Blade here. And takes it out, fair enough. Seems like plus two Decidueye is just going to destroy his her entire team, pretty much. What's next? Drift Blim? That's fine. You already know we can destroy Drift Blim here. Although I don't know if we're faster, that's the only problem I have right now. Let's go for a Spirit Shackle anyway. We are faster. This might not kill, because Driftlin has a lot of HP. It does kill though. Wow, that was the easiest Elite Four member we've had so far. Beatdown's level 51, so he's getting some decent stuff. Noble Roar, what is Noble Roar? Letting out a Noble Roar, the user intimidates the target and slows its attack and special attacks. That's nah, we don't need that. Give up on learning this move. I'm speechless, you've done me in. I mean, it probably would have been a bit more of a challenge if it was Nanu who was doing it, but whatever. Phew! Well, there goes my hopes of beating you to the smithereens and becoming champion myself. Alright. Right, so that's the third one. And we only used Robin in that battle, which is pretty good, to be fair. Right, let's go get the Hyper Potion up, get Robin back up to full-ish health. Okay, I think this one's going to be another problem as well. Yeah, possibly. Wait, hang on, who's this? This is Mallow. Who the hell is that? Am I missing something? Shouldn't it be... Who is this? Who the hell is this? So here you are. Why don't we see whose wind's favored today? You or me? Okay, so she's flying type. Okay, she's flying type. That's fine. Thank God, I thought it was something more difficult then. Who the hell is this though? I've never seen this woman in my life. Let's put Padfoot out front. Oh, Stealth Rock's gonna do so much. A few years ago, I was a champion of the Island Challenge too, just like you. I've been traveling the world to improve my skills as both a trainer and as a golfer. When I heard that they'd make the Pokemon League in my own home region, I came flying back to serve Alola. Have a look at my fantastic flying type Pokemon, okay. Alright then. Challenged by Elite Four Kahili. She's gonna have a Skarmory, I can already. Yeah. Straight away, there's a Skarmory. Otherwise, we would have just destroyed her team without any questions, really. But Stealth Rock will be important here, so we're gonna get the Stealth Rocks up. Although, I still think a boosted Rock Slide will do a lot. So let's go for the boosted Rock Slide. Does it do over half? No, it doesn't. Use spikes. Interesting. Very interesting indeed. Can we get a flinch here maybe? Flinch? Flinched and couldn't move. Right, so we're getting rid of the Skarmory early, which is important, super important. And I mean, unless she goes for a Forged Door, you know, there's that too. Do we have anyone that can take out the Skarmory anyway? We do not. See, Steel is another type that we really struggle with. Flinch. Nope, went for another set of spikes. She's setting up on us as well right now, and I don't have anything to get rid of the spikes. So we're just gonna have to stay in with, right. Oh, that's so close. Steel Wing is gonna hit. It's gonna connect. Is it gonna kill? No, we're living. Right, good. Get the Accelerock off. Get rid of the Skarmory, and we should be able to sweep from here. We should be able to sweep from here. Mandibuzz is coming out. That's going to take a lot of Stealth Rock damage, though. So, I'm going to go for a Hyper Potion again. Oh my god, I've already used 13 of the Hyper Potions. I mean, to be fair, we are on the 4th Elite Four member, so that's not really a big deal. Brave Bird's coming out. Not going to do anything. And it's going to do a bit of recoil damage as well, which means we can go and get a rock slide off. It's not going to kill though. Got the flinch. Go for the Accelerock, get rid of it. Unless, of course, she goes for a full restore. She's just trying. She's just longing this out as much as possible right now. Let's keep going for Accelerocks until we know that a rock slide is going to kill. Flatter. Oh, for God's sake, this is annoying. She's just being unnecessarily annoying right now. Especially if Pavlov's going to hit himself in the face. Brave Bird is just not going to kill. It's going to connect though, so... if we can get off a Rock Slide here, I'll be happy. Snapped out Confusion, went for Rock Slide, right. That Mandibuzz is gone. Okay, so her two fat Pokemon are gone. Hopefully she has no more fat flying types. In the back, chilling. Two Cannon's not particularly fat, I don't think. It's actually the first time I've seen two Cannon in game, it's pretty cool to be fair. Rock Slide will kill. Started heating up his beak. Oh, that's the beak blast, isn't it? Well, never mind, it's dead anyway. Papa got 2k experience, he's now level 57, decent. Glacier's level 51, which is important. Oricorio's coming out. Oricorio's not living anything that we've got for it. Especially when it's already at half, because it's a fire-type Oricorio. Get that shit out of here. And then Crobat's the last Pokemon. I think we can destroy it, Crobat. As long as we can get off the super powerful Rock Slide, we should be able to kill the Fat Bat. Air Slash, I don't think that's going to kill. Oh, we live on 3 and we got Flinch. She got Flinch, though. Go for the Hyper Potion. This battle's taking far too long. Crobat's incredibly quick. I completely forgot that it was so fast. Rock Slide though, we're going to get that off. Is it going to kill? Yes it is. And that's the last member of the Elite Four done. Wesley's level 57 now, which is important. It's frustrating to be to me as a member of the Elite Four, but it seems your strength is the real deal. Decent. You know, I think you'll bring a fresh air to the Alola battle scene. I was honestly annoyed when Kukui kept pestering me to come here, but I'm glad I did. Alright then. Let's go back in here then, and then get ourselves healed up. And then we get to go to... oh, I've connected the dots. That's where Kukui was standing and now he's gone. I think Kukui's the champion. Kukui isn't the champion, I'm going to shoot myself in the foot. Not really, but, you know. I'm just going to go for a couple... maybe an elixir here and there. We have one elixir. Let's use it on Pavlov. I think at this point... do we go for it? You know what, we're going to make this an extra long episode and we're going to go for it. Damn. Is it Kukui? I'm gonna guess it's Kukui. I mean, why? What? So we're sitting down now. What the hell? Yeah, it's Kukui. It's Kukui. Okay, fair enough. Oh yeah, now you're the Pokemon League champion. Wouldn't it be nice if it was that simple? The truth is, there's one more person you have to battle if you want that title. Blep, 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 blep. And of course, that trainer is me, Wu. One final hurrah for your island challenge, and a special tribute as you and this Pokemon League embark on a new path. Let's have a battle worthy of this moment. Fuck with me, Kukui, let's go. Let's go, bitch. So this is how I become champion. Oh, the music! Damn, Kukui's on a madness. He has a Lycan Rock as well. This is gonna be a long ass battle, I can already tell. Go for the Accelerock. No, not the Accelerock, we want to go for... Although that does a lot of damage. He went for the Stealth Rock as well, so he knows his deal, he knows his job. Kukui's not stupid, let's go for our own Stealth Rock here. Went for Stone Edge, Jesus, okay. And that's why you always go for accuracy over power. Oh, never mind. Gonna go for Rock Slide, it's gonna do just as much, I think. If not more. Right, and now we can go for an Accelerock here and take this thing out. So it's advantage us at this. Oh my goodness, no, he's gonna switch out. Okay, he went out on Magma Zone. Kukui knows what he's doing. Okay, so I'm gonna go out into Jonathan here. I really hope that my my capture card stays okay for this battle, because this is important as hell. Magma Zone used Flash Cannon. Oh no, that did so much. Why did that do so much? Gotta go for the EQ here, hoping we outspeed. We don't. It's gonna go for Flash Cannon. Oh, so annoying. That's irritating as hell. Beatdown's not going to be able to take this thing out with one Flash Cannon. Oh, I'm going to take Stealth Rock damage. The Stealth Rock's annoying me. Go for the sword. We outspeed. Magnezone's not fast, but never mind. We don't outspeed anymore. I don't think a Flash Cannon's because that Flash Cannon's going to kill from here, because we are quite specially bulky as well, so... As long as we don't die from this Flash Cannon, we should be okay. Right, can we get it off, please? Thank you. Plus two Sky Uppercut. That Magma Zone's dead. Right, the advantage is back with us again. Ninetales is coming out, so it's going to be a load of Ninetales. We've got to go out to pad for here, don't we? And just go for the Rock Slide and hope and pray. If not, we go. Oh no, we don't have a Mud still, do we? This will do. I mean, yeah, no, we can definitely take it out from here as long as we're faster. Rock Slide, please tell me we're faster. Oh, I went for Ice Shard. No. If we lived that, that would have been the utmost of hype. No, we don't want to go out to Beatdown. Go out to Wesley and go for the first impression. Oh shit, Stealth Rocks, I forgot about Stealth Rocks. First impression, get rid of this thing. Oh wait, no. Oh, it's not very effective, I'm an idiot. Dazzling Gleam. Gonna take Wesley below half and we're gonna have to switch out. Do we go out onto our own one? I'm gonna go out onto our own Alolan Ninetales here. Spite Factor's gonna take a lot of damage. Right, this is the time where we start using the Max Revives, because we have four of them. Let's get Mudsdale, Jonathan back out here. Or do we get we get Padfoot back out, is what we do. Dazzling Gleam, we're living that easy. Let's go for the Z Twinkle Tackle, maybe. If we can get it off. I don't think we are, though. Yeah, we're not getting that off. Right. Come on, Padfoot. We've got to go for this. Celerock, please. Please. Yes! Right, okay. We're good. We're good. Padfoot's level 58 now. Robin's level 58 as well. Okay. Incineroar's coming out. We're faster than Incineroar, we can take it out. We're definitely faster than Incineroar, which means we can take it out. How? I thought we took out more than one Pokemon. Alright, the Incineroar's got... It just lived that. Oh, flinched, quality, right. Celerock. I think he's going to switch out here, or he's going to use a Forestore. Accelerock will do a decent amount though. Right. Hopefully a Rock Slide takes him out. Oh, for God's sake, he keeps living. He's gonna use another Forge Door here. Oh, never mind, no he's not. Right, now he's down to three Pokemon. The Incineroar's gone. Beatdown's level 52. Snorlax is coming out. Oh, goodness gracious me. We've got to go out to Beatdown. I don't think Beatdown can live anything from this, though. Especially because he has the Stealth Rocks up. Ah, it's level 56. Ah, we're not going to live this, are we? We've got to go for a full restore anyway. I feel like the Elite Four is the only difficult part of any Pokemon game, realistically. Unless you count... Okay, we can live another one of those. Let's go for a Swords Dance. Apart from in Black 2 and White 2 and Black and White, it is literally the only... Oh, he went for Heavy Slam this time. That's fine. Where's my max potions gone? Max potion, we have three left. And now Beatdown's at plus two, which means a Sky Uppercut might kill her. Body Slam, I mean unless he gets the Paralysis, which he doesn't, so we're gonna go for Sky Uppercut. Should take him out maybe, possibly. It does, right. It was a crit as well. Okay, I think we're destined to win here. It's gonna send out Bravery. We'll go out to Padfoot again. Padfoot's just putting in the most work right now. As long as we keep him alive, I think we have a chance of winning. And we know Lycanroc is faster than Bravery, which means that we should be able to just get off a nice and powerful Rock Slide here, and it'll take him out. I think. There we go. Alright, we're good. Get that Bravier out of here. Get Bravier out of here, boy. Lycanroc. Oh, it's the his Lycanroc's coming out again. Let's finish it off with Robin, I think. It's only fitting that we finish it off with Robin. I mean, unless he dies to Stealth Rocks. I think he might die to Stealth Rocks, actually. Does he die to Stealth Rocks? Oh, he just about lives. Let's go for the Spirit Shackle, finish it off. Unless he just goes straight out for Full Restore, that's fine. That's also okay. I mean, at this point, it gives us a chance to go for... the Sinister Arrow Raid to finish it off. If we can live this crunch. Which we can. And we're going to finish it off with a Sinister Arrow Raid. With our starter. You couldn't write this kind of story. Can't script this kind of shit. And we finished him off. Robin gets some more experience, so does Padfoot and the rest of the team. And we defeated Pokemon Professor Kukui. I couldn't win, even though I went all out, but what a refreshing feeling. Woo. my guy. Amazing. It's like I told you before, the strongest moves you can use are the ones the trainer and their Pokemon choose together in the heat of the moment, when it really counts. And you just proved me right. Congrats, cousin. You're a champion we can all be proud of. I told you, didn't I? Up there on Mount Hakolani. I mean, to be fair, I want everyone in the world to know that too. That's always been my Oh, I just missed something there. Not bad. And right here, right now, it finally came true. And it's all thanks to you, J-Dot. You and your Lycanroc. And the rest of the team. Don't forget the rest of them. Why am I standing there now? I'm so happy I got to battle you and your team right here, right where my dreams came true. And now, J-Dot, first ever champion of the Alola Pokemon League. It's time we record you and your beloved team's achievements for eternity. Nice. Well, we finally, it looks like we might have actually finished the game, to be fair. Decent. Padfoot. Nice. Robin. Even nicer. Jonathan, having a nice. Wesley, having an even nicer. Beatdown, I didn't have a nice trying to catch him. And Glacier, I had a bit of a nice trying to catch her. So that's fine. We're good. Congratulations, you are Alola's first ever champion. Nice. Pretty decent. I enjoyed that, to be honest. I don't know if we're going to do anything post-game, but we might do. Can we... Oh, right, okay. Got the stamp of approval and everything. Decent. You've entered the Hall of Fame. Spectacular. Much as the sun shines upon the moon. I just spat on my mic. Illuminating it. So have the friends you made during your island challenges illuminated your life. You have grown so much. You really do love your Pokemon with all your heart, don't you, J-Dot? Yep, that's precisely why he and his Pokemon were able to combine their strength to emerge victorious. Now we're all going to aim for your seat. I hope you're ready for some rivals. Bitch! The first ever champion of the Alola Pokemon League. Let's celebrate so grandly that even the sun and moon themselves will take notice. Ha. I see what you did there. What a joker. Alright, J-Dot, let's bust as you turn for Melly Melly Island. We're going to have a big festival in Icky Town. Don't worry, I'll be sure to let Lily know too. Decent. Go. Oh, look, it's all the trial captains as well. I mean, don't quite know what's going on here. Oh, everyone's just meeting the champion first. Cool. Oh, it's Mumsy. Mumsy's back. Just the... You know what to do. No one's saying anything. I'm so confused. Oh, look, there's Lily. I still don't remember, what's her name? I can't remember her name. She was the one who should have been the, Oh, it should have been the, one of the Elite Four. Here he is, the first Pokemon League champion from Alola. This calls for celebration. Let's all go to it. Get to it. I mean, Oh, Gladion's just standing in the corner, Fez. Lily still hasn't changed her clothes back. Oh, okay, fair enough, he's smiling. And then you got Kiawe doing all of his spinning shit. I'm not quite sure what's happening right now. Everyone's just dancing and shit. It's I don't know, it's confusing me. Just a little bit. I mean... Okay. Oh, Nanu as well. Fez. Now there's fireworks and shit. Alright then. QRW still just going ham with the little fire spinning shit. I love how there's no dialogue for me to do. This is just literally just me waiting for the end of the game right now. I should stop speaking. I'm gonna stop. Oh, there we go. J-Doc, congratulations on becoming the champion. It's amazing, isn't it? All these people are here just to help you celebrate this achievement. J-Doc. Everyone looks so happy. The adults, the children, even the Pokemon. It hasn't all been easy, but I'm really glad I came to Alola. Getting to meet you. No, it wasn't just meeting you, it was travelling together with you. I'm so glad I got to be part of that journey. Okay, can we move on a little bit, please? Thank you. Hey, J-Dot, it looks like the party is still going on strong for some time still, wouldn't you say? Do you think maybe we could sneak out for a second and visit the Ruins of Conflict? Are we about to get that pussy? I heard from Kahuna Hala the bridge has been fixed. Sure. Fuck it, let's go. I think Tapu Koko must be waiting. I'm sure it's waiting for you to come to it, J-Dot, now that you've finished your island challenge. Okay. I mean, this episode's already kind of long as is, so... It's gonna have to be an extra long episode, isn't it? The Mahalo Trail, the Plank Bridge. Where it all began. Now this really takes me back. Back then I could barely think about anything, I was so desperate. Desperate?
Girl.
But thinking back on it now, it really was Solgaleo. I mean, it was Nebby who brought the two of us together, wasn't it? Come on, let's go. I mean, like, what's up? You know what I mean? Do we have to do some shit now? I mean, I'm champion already. What the hell? Why have we got to do some extra shit? The Ruins of Conflict. I still wonder why it is that Tapu Koko helped us that day. Was it because of some connection to Solgaleo, the legendary Pokemon of the Alola region? I don't know. Can we... This reminds me of when Hapu became the Kahuna of Pony Island. My heart is pounding in my chest. Hapu, that's the one. Is it because of the Sacred Guardian? Is Tapu Koko here with us? Oh, Jesus Christ. What's going on? What are we doing? Why? Great Tapu Koko, it was because of you that Cosmog lived and was able to become Solgaleo. Please allow me to thank you on its behalf. Thank you so very, very much. It's your turn next, J-Dot. I want to see how you appreciate. I want you to show your appreciation in the way that only the Alola champion could. I know you can do this, J-Dot. I'll make sure your team is ready too. Oh, so we have to battle Tapu Koko. Are we not even going to get... You reach down and touch the statue. Are we not even going to get a say in this? You seem to hear a voice coming in your head, as though it's coming from the Z-Ring. Okay, I don't know why this is going on. I thought this was the end of the game. I don't know why, like, it's just continuing. Capricoco's level 60, Jesus. Do you know what? I ain't got time for this shit. I ain't got time for it. I just haven't got time for this shit. We're just gonna attack catch type of Goku, I don't care. I'll get some more Master Balls eventually. I just don't care. Tapu Koko's date was added to the Pokédex. I mean, I like the fact that we have a Tapu Koko, but I need to finish the episode. You know what I mean? So, let's push next. We're not going to name him for now. Send to a box. A Z crystal clatters to the floor at your feet. The Tapunium Z. Oh, so we can use the Tapu Koko. I know it will aspire to ever greater heights at your side from now on, J-Dot. But I'm so glad we could come here. It has been weighing on my heart. Come on, J-Dot. We should get back to the village. If we don't return soon, everyone will realize that we slipped away from the festival. This is the end of the game now. Like, I don't want to finish the game, but at the same time, like, this episode has been going on for far too long. Everyone looks like they're having so much fun that I don't think they could ever notice we left. Oh, and the battle royales are about to begin. I mean, okay. He's just gonna use a Meowth, fair enough. Just more cutscenes, essentially. It's basically what's happening right now. So we literally just took a break to go and battle Tapu Koko. That's literally it. I mean, this is all well and cool, but you know, I feel like these scenes have been going on for far too long. Oh, what? We're gonna go somewhere else now. It's a beautiful festival, isn't it? Everyone looks so happy. I hope that you'll always stay just the way you are now, J-Dot. Do you look how your joy has brought so much light to everyone here? I think even my mother would have smiled and laughed to see this, if she could have come. I think my mother is getting a bit better. She even tried to come tonight. I've been trying to help her understand what she did wrong, gently of course, but she needed someone to scold her. But in the process, I think I've discovered what I have to do next. What it is that I can do. Okay. J-Dot, I'm going to... Don't know where that was going, but fair enough. Woohoo! She looks like she's fighting with some demons or some shit. I like the kind of girls. Crazy type. Ain't got time for that shit. Look at this, everybody's so fired up, woo. We've got the birth of Alola's strongest ever trained to celebrate after all. And I'm going to keep training with Ilima for a while, and then I'm going to beat my Gramps for real at last. And then I'm coming for you, Champion J. Okay. I'm going to lose every time. J. Sorry, I mean Champion. I'm sure everyone here wants to see your partners too. Come on and show us those partners that were there for so many of your discoveries, new experiences and adventures on your island challenge. Also, am I going to be standing with my mom's now? Is that what's happening? You're positively glowing. So am I not going to get to see my mons? Okay. Alright then. Pokemon Sun, there we go. Alright. It's kind of crazy. A little bit mad. We're finally at the end. And so, J-Dot's Island Challenge came to an end. The festival to celebrate the birth of Alola's first champion lasted until late into the night. We know that, we could tell. It was so much fun. I'm so glad I got to meet you all. Who's talking? These times in Alola will always be my most precious memories. Who's talking? The next day. So there's more. Now I wonder what will happen today. Was that the doorbell? Oh, that's going to be Cuckoo. Why don't you let him in, J-Dot? I mean, I swear he's the guy who he always lets himself in, so... Like, what's up? Oh no, it's... How? J-Dot! It's a total disaster! A total disaster! What's wrong, Hal? Oh, Auntie, hi, sorry. I love how he calls her Auntie. I'll explain later, but J-Dot has to come with me right now. If we don't hurry, the ship is going to leave. I mean... You know, Lily, Kanto is a long way away from here. Try not to let the jet lag hit you too hard. Oh, she's going Kanto. Burnett's, well... She said she's too sad to watch you go, so she wouldn't even come out with me. I know it was a lot to ask, but forgive her this time, one time, would you? She did tell me to let you know the loft in the lab is yours to use indefinitely. So you can come back and stay whenever you like, Lily. Oh, yeah. You didn't tell us! Yeah, bitch. How? I'm sorry. But I've decided I had to go to Kanto to help my mother get better, but more than that, to help myself get stronger. Of course I'm sad to leave Alola. But the thought of going to Kanto also fills my heart with excitement. I'm going to become a real trainer and meet all kinds of wonderful Pokemon. Going to travel all around Kanto, just like we did here in Alola for your island challenges. And no matter what happens on my journey, I'm going to be okay. Because of the smiles that you shared with me, you and J.R. and everyone here. Thank you all so much. Just make sure you be careful on Mount Moon. That place is hard as a bitch to navigate. And that's why someday, I'll come back to Alola again. But I haven't got to say any of the things I wanted to say to you. So, I'm going to send you a letter. A really, really long one. You better wait. Okay, Hal, you need to chill out. I will, Hal, and please, take this. J-Dot, it may look like a little warm, but this is that is because this was my most treasured belonging once. A Pokédoll. Wow. A Pokédoll, really? Then I suppose this is goodbye. I mean, Fez. I thought this was going to be the end of the game. It's such long cutscenes. Trying to beat Metal Gear Solid for like the longest end cutscene of any game ever. I'd like to point out we haven't moved anywhere since like we got to the Champion's Throne. Oh, my man's crying. Okay. How? I know it's like what it's like when you can't help but cry, but you know, you're a little bitch. Oh, when you're saying goodbye to someone you love, you gotta show them one last smile. Yeah. Yeah, I think I wanna go see my gramps. Yeah, let's all go home. We've got people waiting for us. Our families are waiting for us. There we go. Alright, so that is actually the end of the game now. At least I think it is. I hope there's not anything else left afterwards. I'm assuming there isn't. We're just gonna have to watch this a little bit first. Championes, championes. But yeah, that's the end of the game. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to long out the outro for as long as we can, as long as the thing's going to go on for, as long as the credits going to go on for. But really, I know I say it a lot, but I really, 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 truly thank everybody who watches these videos, all the support, the likes, the comments, just the views in general, because they do make my day. Because you know, I do spend a lot of time making these videos. I am at university most of the time. And, you know, as much as I have, it's been difficult for me in the last year or so to try and get videos up as frequently as I would like. Obviously, I've been trying to get it more consistent than I have been. And it's definitely been working. I think the release of these games has really helped that a lot. It's sort of motivated me to try and get out as much content as possible. Good quality content as well. So that's nice. After this, obviously, I think you guys are probably already going to be seeing some Wi-Fi battles I'm going to be uploading as well. Those are going to start going up on the channel. I mean, I've only just finished uploading part 15 on the channel. So at this point, you know, you guys, by the time I get to, you know, part 16 and part 17, you guys are probably going to start seeing Wi-Fi battles, which is kind of crazy at this point. I've already started dabbling in a little bit of Pokemon Showdown. Trying to work out what's good competitively and what isn't. So that should be interesting. It really should be interesting. I'm going to do some Battle Royales, I hope, possibly with subscribers. If people want to start doing Battle Royales, I'll start doing that. But, you know, it's just really, it really is. I mean, it's the end of the game here, but it really isn't the end of the game, because this game is the start of a new chapter in terms of Pokemon YouTube and, you know, Wi-Fi battles and competitively, and it's just a new generation is what it is. So there's going to be a new generation of Pokemon, new generation of YouTubers coming up, you know, people everywhere, and it's going to be really exciting, to be honest. And it's already shown that it's going to be a very exciting time for everybody. But realistically, I don't know what else to say in this outro, to be honest, because this, I feel like this is going to go on for the longest time. But you know, we could try and speed it up a little bit. Can we speed it up? I think that's the end of it, isn't it? Character modeling? No. I don't know how I'm going to long this out even more. But I think we've just got to end it off with, like I said, thank you guys so, so much for watching. All the support is just incredible. I know that even in the trying times, especially with the way YouTube's changing at the moment, you know, the views and the stuff and some people being unsubscribed from channels, it's all very difficult to keep track of things, but it seems like I'm getting a little bit of support, even if it isn't, you know, a massive, massive amount of support that the other bigger YouTubers get. I appreciate every single view. So really, well and truly, if you're watching this now, thank you so much. Realistically, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. But I really don't know. We've got to try and just wait this out, because I feel like there's going to be something else at the end. Possibly. You know, I'm going to cut to the end after this. I'll wait for a second. Everyone's smile shines so brightly. Honestly, I would not have been able to talk through that entire, like, 10 minutes. Those smiles led us to be Fuck, I fucked it up. And those meetings will lead us to a brighter future. Inspirational words. I'm so glad I got to meet everyone. I don't even know who this is talking. I'm so glad I got to meet you. Okay. Pokemon Sun. Well, that is the end of that. Honestly, like I said, thank you guys so much for watching. I will be up out, and I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.